Hey guys, thanks for joining me again. Today we're looking at bass and four magic frequencies which are going to help you get into the ballpark with bass. Now it's taken me absolutely years to figure out how to work with bass and to be honest, I probably still don't get it all right all the time now. God, my glasses need cleaning. Brand new set of glasses. And filthy already. So, we're going to look into bass and what makes a bass sound great. So, generally speaking, you're looking at power in the bass and presence in the bass. So, your first frequency on that basis is going to be 1 kHz. 1K on a bass is going to give you that sort of presence on smaller systems. iPhones, laptops, earpods, AirPods, whatever, that kind of thing. So let's jump into Pro Tools and I'll show you. I'm working with Come and Haunt Me by Mars Blossom again. And here's just the bass tone. If I bypass the SSL and I'll bypass the compressors, the raw bass DI's this. Now I've added the Sansamp PSA1 on there just to give it a little bit more amp tone. So 1K, let's see what this does. It's also worth mentioning that depending on the tuning of the bass and the type of bass sound you got, 1K may need to be shifted a little ways, 600, 700, 800, somewhere around there. Generally speaking, 1K is a great starting point though. And just play around with it and shift it a little bit if you need to get that kind of mid-range grit and presence that you're looking for. All right, onto the second frequency. The second frequency is a little above that. It's about 1.5 to 2K. I start at 1.5 usually, and that's for that kind of high-end slappy pick attack sound that you want. Let's have a look. Now obviously I'm mixing this bass in context with the drums because one should never mix in solo. Don't forget the golden rule. It's kind of honky, but honky good way, not honky bad way. Okay. Third magic frequency. This is going to be a low pass filter. So around about 4K. 4.5, something like that. Basically what we want to get rid of is the hiss, the whistle, the top end shit that we just don't need. A bass is a bass is a bass. You don't want it to be a guitar. It should mesh with the two. And by lopping off anything above 4K, that helps the guitars to shine here and the bass to shine here. Love the hand gestures. All right, 4K. Let's put that in. You see, it doesn't make that much of a fundamental difference to the tone of the bass, but what it does get rid of is the filth up above it that we really don't need. So, generally speaking, good starting point, 4K. All right, your fourth frequency. This is going to be a range. So, 100 Hz and below, you want to boost. Now, depending on the tuning of the bass, if it's in standard, drop D, drop A, etc., depending on how heavy the music is that you're working with, the fundamental notes of that will shift down accordingly. So around about 100 Hz down generally covers it. Sometimes I go up to like 150 depending on the bass, but usually around 100. You want a nice boost there. You don't want to use a bell. You want to use a shelf, because if you use a bell, that is going to lift one of the notes out and then the rest are going to be under it. So you'll end up with one note on the bass that's really loud. You don't want that. You want a boost on a nice shelf and lift all the notes together. You want that low-end balls, that power. And to do what a bass does, which is provide low-end power. I'll use an SSL for this in this example, but in fact, you know what? Screw it. Let's use a Pultec, because why not? All right, Pultec, 100 hertz. Oh, let's boost that shit. And here's what that would have sounded like on the SSL. See, it's pretty nice on the SSL, but the Pultec just does a thing. It's just huge. Let's A/B again. Now, you will have noticed throughout this video, I didn't talk about any EQ cuts. Generally speaking, if you boost in top end and you boost in low end, you are actually cut in the middle. But should you find the bass is a little bit too honky and it's still kind of a bit woolly sounding, then I'd head for the 350 to 700 hertz range. So that's your bonus frequency in today's video, folks. So 350 to 700, roughly. Cut a little bit of the snot out of it. You'll hear it. If you boost first and sweep around, you're going to hear where the bass gets woolly and fluffy and boxy and sounds like ass. Suck that out and you'll notice that the clarity, it blooms like magic. Cool. So that's bass. A quick starting guide to get you in the ballpark. I noticed that as the channel started to grow a little bit more, there's a lot of you out there watching who are not subscribed. Yes, it's time for the good old YouTuber's plea. Please consider subscribing, it's free of charge, and it'll be nice if I could earn a living off YouTube, I'll be honest. Stick the subscribe button on there, whack the bell notification, all that kind of thing. Now, drop a comment below if you've got any thoughts, if you want to tell me about your process, plugins you find useful, or even bits of hardware. Let's have a little chat about it down below. Other than that, I'll see you next time with another video, and thanks a lot for tuning in again. Take it easy.